Welcome to Riesenbeck Stage 11 of the Global Champions League, including this stage. We have just five stages left in the season. Five stages left to secure the top four. Five stages left to go on and win the title. And five stages left to get as high as you can up the standings to give yourself a better start position at the GCL Super Cup quarterfinals powered by Airbank in Prague later on this year. Welcome to GCTV. My name is Mark Lewis, and as you can see, this absolutely immaculate, gorgeous Riesenbeck ring behind us, and every single rider that I've caught up with over the last 48 hours has spoken to me with such excitement about being able to jump on this ring. The odd shape of it, the uniqueness of it, and the wonderful surface of the lawn just makes it something to behold. And what an incredible facility that's been built here as well. So many warm-up rings, so many stables available to the riders. It really is a rider and horse dream to be here in Riesenbeck for the very first time in the 2023 season. So where does the show go today? What do we focus on? For the Stockholm Hearts powered by H&M, this is the do or die weekend. This is the weekend that they cannot, absolutely off the back of two eliminations, afford any more slip-ups. Let's show you quickly just how it looks now and give you an idea as to, at the moment, as to how things are looking here in Global Champions League, because it gets very, very intriguing as we start getting more into this point. There is the top four. Riesenbeck still lead by 30 points. Madrid Emotion and Paris Panthers currently holding on to 2 and 3, and the Saint-Tropez Pirates still very much in the mix. But look at the points difference between the Prague Lions, Stockholm Hearts, and Saint-Tropez Pirates. It is getting incredibly tight, and between those teams, we know that the gap is absolutely minimal. Any team that underperforms at one particular stage or overperforms at a particular stage is going to take a massive leap, a massive jump into those GCL Super Cup stages later on this year. Speaking of the 2022 title contenders in the Stockholm Hearts, and now somewhat struggling to stay within reach of the 2023 Super Cup semi-finals, Grace Kelly caught up with Olivia Philippaerts from the Stockholm Hearts.
I'd say it's make or break nearly every week, but I'd say after last week we actually dropped two spots, so it's for us very important to climb back a few spots. We're only five shows left to go, so we really have to make it happen now.
And being 19 points, sorry, behind the team in fourth position, how can you guys pull together to maybe make some results this weekend?
Well, I mean, I think we brought the best horses possible to get some points this week. So I basically think that we should be able to get some points again.
And only two riders this weekend, yourself and Marlon. Have you a plan put in place yet?
Yeah, it's again Marlon and me. We've been struggling a little bit the last couple of shows to get enough rides in all the competitions. We had a few injuries, riders, horses. So it's been a bit of a struggle to get enough people to the shows. But I hopefully now, from now towards the end, we've got more people wanting to go to the show, so we're really hoping to get some more points towards the end of the season. I think we tried to do in the other shows to use our second horse for the first round and our Grand Prix horse for the second round. And obviously it's a bit of a small risk, but on the end the season is so long, so we had to do it to get the horse in shape till the end. But I think Marlon will jump Indiana both rounds tomorrow, so let's say that's an advantage for our team. And I will jump Blue Diamond and Legend of Love in the second round. So I think this plan is the best plan we can make. And yeah, I'm pretty confident we can get up the ladder a bit.
Is that not a very, very interesting admission from Olivia Philippaerts? The fact that we now have been confirmed though, that Marlon Bayard-Johnson will jump H&M Indiana in both rounds. Now, we know so often with the Global Champions League round one and round two that maybe a slightly less experienced horse will come in for round one. And then with the LGCT Grand Prix qualification on the track for round two, that's normally where those big horses come in. H&M Indiana with Marlon will jump both round one and round two, signifying the importance, signifying the intent from the Stockholm Hearts. They know how crucial it is this weekend for them to perform and for them to really try and get off the back of those two eliminations and make up real strides in that fight for the top four. They know based on their lineups, based on their horsepower, that they are a top four contending team, if not even a championship contending team. But things have just not been going their way. Marlon Bayard-Johnson, Olivia Philippaerts, only two riders this weekend for the Stockholm Hearts. Pressure will be on them. Now, standing inside this gorgeous gorgeous Riesenbeck ring. Frederik de Backer standing by for us. Frederik, let's talk about lineups already. Confirmation then from the Stockholm Hearts that H&M Indiana will jump both round one and round two. That's a big signal of intent from Stockholm. We know Paris looks great. Talk to me about who looks really good this weekend. Let's talk about round one lineups. What for you?
Riesenbeck International. Championship leaders are very strong, of course. Coming out with the two 90-year-old horses, Zita Day and Just Be Gentle. But those horses have proven their value already. Paris Panthers, they're right up the hills for Paris Panthers. It's not so much a break or make or break weekend, but still, if Paris Panthers want to keep this championship race alive, they have to produce the goods. They have to try to get in front of Riesenbeck at the end of this stage here in Riesenbeck, outperform the home team. They've brought good riders, Smolders, Veeling, Mayer. Horse-wise, strong, but maybe not as reliable as Riesenbeck. So maybe already in round one, we see a little bit of a shift. Then if we talk number three, Madrid in Motion, not the strongest lineup. Equine America Van Middelalanden, no clears just yet. And also Luigi de Clips is a new horse in GCL for Michael van der Vleuten. So that's somewhat of a weaker team. Then we go to team four, Saint-Tropez Pirates. Very strong with... With Cayman Jolly Jumper and with Ben, two horses that do really well on grass for Simon de Lestre and for Gerrit Nieberg. Then, as you already mentioned, Stockholm Hearts, but that's a team in six. Stockholm Hearts with Le Blue Diamond, one in H&M Indiana, very strong lineup right there. But the team that sits in the middle of that is Prague Lions, a team that we've discussed already a lot with their round one difficulties. Again, in round one, coming out fairly light. Johnny Paul, Scuriano van Mare, it's only their second show together. So that is an untested combination. They haven't been secured, they haven't been long together for a long time. And then Peter de Vos with his 9-year-old Yarina jumped to clear already. But again, as the season progresses, the season gets more and more difficult as well, especially when it is now the time. It's mattering now. So if you look at those top six teams, you could say that Madrid and Prague come in with the more weaker teams, but all the others, where normally through the season we've seen round one being moderate to light, now you see that those other teams in top six, they come out with very strong horses. They know that the time is now. There's a 2-week break coming up. The horses can rest. They want to get as many points out of this stage already now before going into that break, and they want to jump the good horses in round one and in round two. So they're really showing muscle, all of them, except for Prague and Madrid.
And Frederik, before I let you go very quickly, what about Shanghai Swans? They come in the lineup this weekend. That could well be a major point-stealing team this weekend. Remind us who's lined up for Shanghai Swans and what they could potentially do by the end of the night.
Well, there's no Christian Almon in that team in round one. So they've got Max Kudu with Electric Blue, and they have got the Daniel Doser on Bingo Saint-Hermel. Very strong team, no doubt about that. But of course, the team sits quite low on the championship standings. This could very well be the stage where they finally make up enough ground to leapfrog a group of teams. They can easily climb up 3 to 4 places on the standings if and only if they do really well. They need that podium mark, and just on paper, on horsepower, they've got the material to make a podium. But like we said, from the top six, we already have 4 teams that also have that firing power. So for all teams in the championship race, this is going to be a very, very intense stage.
All right, Frederik de Backer, thank you very much. We'll let you get on with your course walk. We'll come back to you in a few moments' time, speaking to us about what the round one lineup looks like, who is looking strong, who maybe is looking ever so slightly light. And I still have a feeling that whether Daniel Doyser and Max Kuhn are for the Shanghai Swans, Bingo Setemel and Electric Blue P, very, very strong this weekend. Can they make up some ground as well? They come into this weekend's event in 12th place on the Global Champions League standings. I wonder if you put a tiny little star by the Shanghai Swans, last team to go in GCL round one, could they make a big splash here in Riesenbeck? We take a quick break. When we return, more in the build-up to Global Champions League Round 1. Stay with us. We'll be back in a moment. Welcome back to GCTV. Welcome back to the Riesenbeck International Arena here in Germany. Stage 11 of the Global Champions League. We are hopefully trying to get our hands on the Paris Panthers before the end of the course walk. Very intriguing to see their mentality. If you recall, and I hope you would have watched the day after from A Coruña, we spoke to Yoli Mitilineo about it, about their championship ambitions, about their belief to still be the only true title contenders along with Riesenbeck International. We'll see if we can ask that question to either Ben Mayer or Jürg Frieling, the two Paris Panthers riders who come out to compete in that ring, in this very ring, later on this afternoon. And the irony is that this ring if you think about it, is one of the biggest that we will see throughout the entire season. So big, in fact, that it makes other previous rings that the riders have competed in look incredibly, incredibly small. Let's put into perspective just what this Riesenbeck International Arena looks like in the context and perhaps alongside the smallest ring of the year, which is Monaco. 75 by 28 meters is the Monaco ring. And take a look at how many of those Monacos fit into this giant 150 meter by 90 meter Riesenbeck ring. You can quite literally fit six Monaco rings inside this Riesenbeck International ring, and it provides space. It allows the riders and the horses to really open up, and it gives them the perfect opportunity to really get some blood flowing in this Riesenbeck ring. And because of that, we hope for a really exciting, really aggressive approach from a lot of the riders today. And I wonder if during the course walk as well, Frederik de Backer might give us a little more information just as to how this giant, enormous ring is going to play out for the riders, for the horses that have been selected as well, and how then that is going to play for them. Speaking of course walk, well, Frederik de Backer is standing by. Let's find out what exactly has been put together here in Riesenbeck. This is course walk.
This is course walk of Global Champions League Round 1, and one of the first things that really catches our eye, and not just our eye, probably also the horse's eye, is this huge Liverpool at fence 4. I mean, you would think it's an open water, but it's huge. It's a little bit at the front end, but look at how far this comes into the line. Lots of horses will look at this, and I'm really thinking about the young horses that might get a little bit spooky about this and will be a little bit hesitant to really take on this jump at fence 4. The rails on top, colorful, as if they were painted by Mark Lewis himself. And then a deep landing into this line. They land more or less here. Now, what you don't really see because it's so big, but there's actually quite some slope and undulation on this ring. And we're going slightly downhill. And as you walk, it walks as four strides. But if some horses are a little bit shaky there from that Liverpool, get a little bit drifting into this line, just might be that on the downhill slope you get a touch too close on your five strides and you would take that plank off. So having the confidence to jump that with a confident horse and then balancing well in the downhill slope, slide downhill slope, it's not as strong as in Madrid, by the way, just to get well set up for fence five here. That seems to be one of the crucial points very early on already. Then it takes us around the GC playoffs vertical and into another line. It's double combination, slightly up the hill, going the other direction, so it's up the hill, obviously. 6A, 6B, and you feel it already. As you're walking, this is going uphill. Beautifully decorated, by the way, in this huge ring. This here is more or less the highest point. If you stand here, that way it's kind of a plateau, goes downhill there, goes downhill in that direction, so also uphill. There it stays a little bit flatter, maybe a slight downhill slope from 6 to 7. But you just want to walk it because A, distance-wise, and B, slope-wise, call it ground-wise, this is a little bit of a downhill run. And if you make your way over, you will feel that it runs just a touch short at fence 7. We'll just quickly catch Gerrit Niebuhr, who tries to move away from the camera, shy as he is. Gerrit, I'm sorry. Ben, how will Ben handle 6 to 7? How will you ride him? What is your plan in this line?
I'm going to do 6 rides, and it's more or less like normal, maybe a little bit short for me. And yeah, it's the first class for him this weekend, so.
Is you didn't jump him yesterday?
No.
Okay, so really fresh out of the box.
Yes.
All right. It starts uphill, coming into the combination, then downhill. Could this become an issue, this entire line? Is there any specific type of horse, combination, experience-wise, stride-wise, where we need to pay attention to the riders coming into this class?
It's for sure going to be like tight for a few riders or for a few horses. Yeah, like you said, it's like going down a little bit. But yeah, more or less like normal six, I think, at the end.
You're not too worried, of course. It's a different situation if you're riding, Ben. Good luck, first team to go. And of course, fighting for top four, just made their way into top four there. Gerrit Nieberg with Central Bay Pirates, who, by the way, makes his season debut. Last year, he was an Istanbul Sultan, Istanbul Warrior, if you want. And now he comes back as a Central Bay Pirate. Then he takes us, Peter Schumacher, by the way, not related, takes us into another double combination as Olivier Philippard takes all the time he needs to get ready. Hi, Olivier. Say hi to millions and millions of viewers. There we go. You're a star now. And then this very flimsy, look at this. There's nothing here. Very flimsy vertical red rails. We know that red rails always jump well because horses don't see the color as strong. And if you just turn and you see where we are going there at 10A, if you just turn, yeah, you turn that way, 10A, 10B, that's where we need to go, and it's slightly on the bend. Now, there is an option for an inside line or an outside line. I don't know what the right option would be to 10A and 10B, because it's the third of three combinations. It is a triple bar to a plank, something you don't find very often. Oh, we quickly talk with, as it is, this is the big Nieberg family show. We just talked to your son. Nowhere near your accolades and your performances. Lars Nieberg, how are you doing? It's good to see you here.
Thank you very much.
Are you doing well?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What did you tell Gerrit about jumping that vertical and then coming into this double combination?
I think 8.
Is there anything particular? Because if you look at it, it looks very special. Triple bar to a wavy plank, we don't see that often.
Yeah, it's not easy. The horses have to be very, really careful.
If you say it's 8, is that 8 through the center? Is that 8 outside, 8 inside?
It's up to your horses. For us, it's a little bit outside.
A little bit outside. Okay, tell me about it. Is then Ben a big striding horse?
Yeah.
That's why he has to take the outside curve, okay? Lars Nieberg, sorry for interrupting you, and thank you very much for talking to us. The man who rode for pleasure, of course, in the Olympics, Olympic champion himself, Lars Nieberg, and father of the super talented Gerrit Nieberg. We're almost at the final stretch, as after the combination, you see we jump this wavy plank, and then it's a rollback to Ludger's horse feet. You roll back, and then into the final line, which sits right here at fence 12. We're just going to chat in on this. Geir Gulliksen and Trevor Breen, do not tell me that you're already trying to sign this man for next year.
We cannot tell you all the confidential things, you know, like, so this, you know, if you can keep a secret, you know, like, it might happen, you know.
And you are really one of the top performers of the league so far, coming in truly on merit. Are there already teams chatting to Trevor Breen come in for next year?
It's all confidential at the moment. Listen, I'm just delighted to be here and play my part for Rome Gladiators, and it's great. It's been a huge, brilliant experience so far this year, and hopefully continues today.
I hear it's all confidential. I just let you talk. Just if you continue talking here, it's about money. The microphone will pick it up. So just so you know, we are here at the final fence. Well, that was Geir Gulliksen alongside of Trevor Breen, who truly is one of those leading riders of the tour, especially for Rome Gladiators. Mark, back to you.
Right, Ferry, stay there. Put your mic out. Let's get some of that inside information. I like that. Look at Geir Gulliksen doing some business inside a course walk here in the Riesenbeck. Trevor Breen has been outstanding. 4 out of 7 clears for the Rome Gladiators, powered by ClipMyHorse.tv. He has been outstanding for the team. They are 15s to go later on this afternoon. Speaking of outstanding, well, the Paris Panthers in A Coruña in particular were outstanding, going on to win the stage. Because of that, we had Yoeli Mutilineo come in to the day after. And now, thinking back to those comments that were made, she was incredibly confident about talking championship. Let's remind you what the Paris Panthers rider had to say. 30 points separate the Riesenbeck International and Paris Panthers. Many would say that Paris are the only team that are true championship threats to Riesenbeck. There is 30 points difference between the two teams. Is that doable for Paris Panthers?
5 stages 100%.
Left. 100%? So is there true belief that 30 points
are... True belief. Like, we have such strong riders in our team. And like I said, I'm not doing any more of them, but I've got so much faith in them that they can pull it off. I'll be watching. But
so that's the wonderful emotional sport response. So Yoli Mitilineo, absolutely confident, no doubt whatsoever that despite it being 30 points with just a handful of stages left, that the Paris Panthers can indeed and will indeed go on to rope Riesenbeck in and go on to win the 2023 title. Well, let's see if that belief echoes through the entire team. Ben Mayer standing by alongside with Grace Kelly. Now, Grace, let's hear from Ben.
Look, Ben, a superstar lineup for Paris Panthers this weekend. You're along with Ur and Harry. How much pressure is on the team now, lying in second place?
We had a better run the last couple of shows. Should I start again? Or?
Yeah.
We had a better run the last couple of shows. Last week, I'd obviously had a very good result. So Riesenbeck a long way ahead, but we keep pushing now. I think we said last week we have some strong horses and riders to come through at the end, and hopefully that can make the difference for us.
And Ben, over the next five stages, do you believe you have the chance of winning the championship?
I think we have the chance to come from behind. Sometimes there's more pressure in front. It all depends if Riesenbeck opens the door for us one time. So if they open the door, hopefully we're there and we're ready. But all we can do at this point is to keep trying to push, keep the pressure on. And like we had in Stockholm, we had one problem and it cost us a lot of points. Can happen for any rider or any team. So we do the best we can, and time will tell.
And lastly, you are knocking on the door behind Riesenbeck International. We caught up at Yoli last weekend. She said she's full confidence in you guys winning the championship. Do you share that same confidence?
Absolutely. We have to be positive as a team. I like Loli's confidence, and we are a team. We're using everybody, all of the horses, all of the riders, and that's why I think we have a little bit more strength at the end of the season.
Super. Thanks so much, Ben.
Huge confidence from Ben Mayer. That really echoing through the entire Paris Panthers lineup that they can indeed go on to win this title. It is not over just yet. There is still a lot of work to do, though, from the Paris Panthers team, and will need something very special, not just here in the Riesenbeck, but over the next five stages as well, if they are to indeed run them down. Speaking of Riesenbeck, speaking about wonderful combinations, Christian Kukuk and Mumbai in particular are quite literally here at home in the Riesenbeck. In fact, the team may well go on compete here, but they live just down the road. The entire Riesenbeck International lineup, all sharing that community, all training, living, and spending time together as a unit every single day. 8 out of 12 clears for Christian Kukuk and Mumbai. Just 1.4 penalties per round. The highest points contributor to Riesenbeck International in the 2023 season. Well, I went to the stables yesterday and was given the opportunity to catch up with Christian Kukuk and Mumbai.
We have Mumbai here. If Mumbai and me, we are coming in the Riesenbeck International look in the ring, you better pay attention.
You are the highest contributor in points to Riesenbeck International, the two of you. So talk to me about the form that both of you find yourself.
All the work we had over the last years pays out now. He is, I would say, in the best age you can have now. He's 11. Oh, we know each other for 5 years now. Actually, when the season started in Doha, we started with a double clear round, and I had a very, very good feeling on him, and that gave me a good feeling for the other shows. We had a lot of self-confidence. I think it's a lot about trust. I trust him 100%, he trusts me. All the work and all the experience we had in these years together just pays out in this moment now.
Can you tell us a little bit about his breeding?
He has by the very famous Diamante Simili, which produced already many, many, many Grand Prix horses. But the special thing is actually his mother side. Many, many, many good horses, like, for example, Eureka from Michael van der Vleuten is from this line. So it's a very approved bloodline. I would say physically he's in the best shape he ever was. Now he looks really ready now. He's 11, like I said. Muscle wise and also he has a nice size. He's not too long but not too short. He has a nice neck, nice feet. The general conformation is just good, and physically he's just in a top shape. I know him so long now. You shouldn't come without a candy to his box, then he gets quite angry with you actually. After 10 seconds he gets annoyed and just turns away. said, okay, if you don't have anything for me, what do you want? But he was a stallion and, you know, he was a bit screaming around. He was always excited when I rode him. When I came to a show, it was impossible to walk him. Mm. As soon as he came from the truck, I had to get on him, and then it was only cantering. But over the years, he got much relaxer. The dressage fledge work, which is quite important for me, he did not really care about in the beginning, I have to say. There were some arguments we had. But what makes him really special, even if there was an argument, like he did not really understand what I want from him, he never ever in his life gave me the feeling in the moment that he doesn't want to try or want to do anything. You know, I could feel it's hard for him, and he didn't learn it when he was young, so it was difficult to understand in that moment. But he never got against me, you know. Even if it took a while, I always had the feeling he goes with me, and he wants to do it. And the good thing with him, you know, he's not scared about anything. Like, he would jump through a fire for you.
What a line from Christian Kukuk. He will jump through fire for you. That is the trust. That is the relationship between this pairing of Mumbai and Christian Kukuk, the highest point contributor to the current championship leaders of Riesenbeck International, powered by Kingsland. And again, ironically, are we going to see Mumbai come in for round two? Just Be Gentle will be coming out for round one, as Riesenbeck International once again play this game of jumping Global Champions League rounds with huge confidence with nine-year-olds. Just Be Gentle and, of course, Zinedae, both only nine. 4 out of 5 clears, 2 out of 2 clears for the pairing. They know how to do it on any type of horse. Before we continue with Riesenbeck, let's remind you about what took place in A Coruña a week ago and look back at that famous Paris Panthers victory.
Welcome, Shuncho Big Fans, to Global Champions League in A Coruña in Spain.
Rome Gladiators, powered by Clip My Horse. Oof. Oh, no, don't do that. Don't do that, Sacorado Blue. Stalls in the turn, loses time. And now, championship moment here. Oh. Stuhlmeier rolls the first rail. Here come Paris Panthers. Harry Smulders with Monaco NOP for the Paris Panthers, and it is a podium finish indeed. Here comes Scandinavian Vikings. Oh! Marlon Modulo Zanotelli gets a little bit out of balance there to the vertical and has it down, and so it is a win for Paris Panthers.
I think towards the end of the season, the horsepower is crucial. I think in our team we have that. So hopefully towards the end of the season we even can move up in the standings.
Paris Panthers in high belief, but as long as Riesenbeck International continue to get onto the podium, you would imagine that they would still be able to hold a big enough lead to get over the line and win the title in 2023. We go one stage further, one dive deeper into that season here this afternoon on GCTV. Stay with us as Global Champions League Round 1 is next.